Hi, I'm Martina and today I'm looking at how HS2 gets past Birmingham, including the airport interchange station and the two planned junctions in the route. We'll start here on the A45, approaching Birmingham and its airport from Coventry. The A45 is well used to being bullied by other infrastructure in the area. Here it's had a bulge put in when the airport runway was extended by 2014. The junction of the A45 and M42 is this unusual tilted three-level roundabout, a notorious congestion hotspot, especially when there's a show on at the NEC. That's why a new link road is being built from the M42 south to the A45 west and airport. This drone footage was made possible by the gracious accommodation of the airport and air traffic control. Do not fly a drone here without permission. You could endanger air traffic and the police might come and shoot you. Back to HS2, here buried walls are being built beneath the A45, so it can be put on bridges and HS2 dug in a trench underneath. Just to the north will be Birmingham Interchange Station. A new people mover will connect this to the NEC, the existing Birmingham International Railway Station and the airport. The renders are mostly foliage, but there will be substantial parking. With the location among several motorways, this will function as a parkway station. Along the line to the north, a new roundabout is being built directly over the line. This will replace the former roundabout over but not connecting with the M42, giving access to the NEC from the M6 and A446, as well as Birmingham Business Park. HS2 begins to rise and crosses the M42 on a bridge in the middle of that former roundabout. Because of the shallow angle of that crossing, the bridge will take the form of large rectangular platforms above the motorway. It seems they will leave some room for future widening, an unusual luxury for the M42. To the north, HS2 then crosses the M6, as well as some slip roads to the M42 and Junction 4. Continuing to rise, HS2 here is partly on embankment, partly on viaducts as it approaches the Delta Junction. This is the junction between the HS2 mainline and the Birmingham spur, connecting to Curzon Street Station, both of which I looked at in previous videos. Go check them out if you haven't seen them. Much of the Delta Junction will be elevated on high concrete viaducts for the high speed lines to cross each other, as well as the motorways that interchange here. Here is the southern fork of the Delta Junction. The HS2 main line heading north is to the right, the Birmingham spur to the left. The main line crosses the M42 for a second time here, multiplexed with the M6 toll. Meanwhile, the core to the Birmingham spur crosses the slip roads from the M42 southbound to the M6 north, and vice versa. Further north, where the main line passes by Cosel, the other cord from the Birmingham spur to HS2 heading northwards also crosses the M42 and M6 toll, here 12 lanes, with the cord on a high viaduct. With the extreme angle, the render shows columns being needed in the current carriageway, so look forward to those roadworks. Work has already been ongoing here for years now to prepare. One of the first jobs was moving and extending pylons to take them out of the way. HS2 passes very close to Hansall Distribution Park, built on the site of a former power station. There's still a major National Grid substation here, as well as distribution substations feeding power to the Midlands. So there's a lot of power lines up to 400 kilovolts crisscrossing the area. Immediately north of the Delta Junction will perhaps be the fork between the Western line towards Crewe and the troubled Eastern Phase 2 line towards Nottingham and onto Yorkshire. The Western line is under construction to the other side of Lichfield, and a little north of here HS2 crosses the M42 for a fourth time at the Marston Box Bridge, seen in my first video. If you like this video, I'd really appreciate if you could click the things or leave a comment. That really helps the channel and has encouraged me to get this far. I have more videos planned, including a bit more HS2, as well as other infrastructure and engineering projects. If you want to see those, click subscribe. In the meantime, I'm Martina, and thank you for looking at things with me.